What is an analytic function? What is Cauchy-Riemann condition and its proof? If you are a physics student, especially student of MSc physics, then you have to know about analytic function and Cauchy-Riemann condition in complex variable theorem. You read it in mathematical physics. Today we are going to discuss about these two topics, analytic function and Cauchy-Riemann condition. These two topics are interlinked to each other, so it's very important topics. First of all, let me discuss about analytic function. It is easy to understand. If you have a function fz, then fz is said to be an analytic function. Analytic function if it has single value in a region R in complex plane. Complex plane means I think you know about complex number. So in complex number we treat x axis as real axis and y axis as complex axis. So we take z is equal to x plus I y. In other words, analytic function can be defined as fz is an analytic function if it satisfies Cauchy-Riemann condition. Cauchy-Riemann conditions are given as below. So if fz is a function of two real variables, that is u of xy and b of xy. This means u is a function of x and y, b is also a function of x and y. So that Cauchy-Riemann condition becomes del dou u by dou x is equal to dou v by dou y, and dou u by dou y and dou v by dou x. Here comes minus, so we have two conditions which are known as Cauchy-Riemann condition. If a function, any function fz, satisfies these two conditions, then we can call this function as analytic function. So here, if fz is analytic, so definitely the derivative of fz, especially first derivative, must exist. Otherwise, it will not be an analytic function, because we define dou u by dou x and dou u by dou y, dou v by dou x, dou v by dou y in Cauchy-Riemann condition. To prove Cauchy-Riemann condition, we define z is equal to x plus iy. Here, i refers complex number or imaginary number. Square of I gives minus 1. I hope you are familiar with the value of I. So here x and I are real number, order pair number, and z, which is defined as x plus I y, is a complex number. Here we defined del x and del y as small increments in x and y. Then del z is equal to del x plus I del y. So we use here the limiting case. Del z tends to 0, or del x tends to 0, del y tends to 0. We use these conditions or limiting cases. Here we defined e of z is equal to u plus iv, where u is function of x and y, also v is function of x and y. So now del f is equal to del u plus I del v. After doing this we use limiting case. For this we take small increments in z, x and y, and taking del z tends to 0. This means variation in z is very small, nearly equal to 0. So limit del z tends to 0, del of f by del of z. This is definition of derivative of f with respect to z. So f means we have defined del f is equal to del u plus I del v, and del z means del x plus I del y, because z is equal to x plus I y. After assuming this, we take two cases when del y is equal to 0 and del x equal to 0. First of all, taking del y equal to 0, then limit del z is equal to 0, del f by del z is equal to limit. So we have assumed del y is equal to 0, so del y obviously vanishes. Then we take del x tends to 0, limit del x tends to 0, del u plus I del v by del x. So by definition of derivative, limit del z tends to 0, del f by del z means del do f by do z. Now we consider del x is equal to 0, so obviously we take limit del z equal to 0, del f by del z is equal to limit del y tends to 0. Here del x is equal to 0, so del x vanishes. Remaining terms are del u plus I del v by del y. So by definition of different derivative, it becomes del u plus I del v by del y. This is equation 2. So we have obtained two equations for limit del z tends to 0 del f by del z. So these two are equal. Then we compare real and complex parts in equation 1 and 2. We get, then what do we get is, so first of all we consider real parts del u by del x is equal to del y, del v by del y. So if we notice on the equation 1, dou u by dou x is a real part, and if we notice in equation 2, dou v by dou y is real part, because their I and I cancels out. Comparing these two equations, real parts gives, real part gives us del u by del x equal to del v by del y, and imaginary parts gives us del u by del y is equal to minus del v by del x. So these two are this and this two equations are known as Cauchy-Riemann conditions in complex variables. These conditions are very important